Hello everyone, how are you doing? So today I'm going to go over the softwares we used in industry. The purpose behind this video is to help you understand that you have a master's degree, you have some sort of internship experience as well, or in case you have a previous experience as well. But you are not getting the number of calls, you are not getting selected, your resumes are not getting shortlisted in the positions you are applying. So one of the bigger reason is you worked as quality documentation coordinator, or you worked as quality assurance associate, or worked as regulatory affairs, and you have wrote it down everything in your resume that you have a skills in good documentation practices, 21 CFR part 11, you know about the various guidance document that came out recently. You are excellent in your conceptual understanding, you are very good, you are ready with the examples. But some job descriptions need the keywords of software industry are using. So when you apply, keep a close eye or look the job description closely. Watch it. Sometime company put that we are using this software and we need somebody who have familiarity or something similar to this software can be very beneficial for us to screen this candidate and shortlist. So give yourself some time, see your resume and look back and see in which internship, co-op or any type of experience you gain, what type of software you used. So this whole video is on software used in life science industries and how to add these softwares in our resume can increase our probability to getting at least shortlisted. Like for a quality documentation job, right now 100 people are applying for one position and you have the similar expertise to them, but if you put keywords related to the software you worked upon, various type of documents you worked upon, your probability of getting shortlisted in the resume screening is higher. So let's go ahead and look at it, look at the different type of department first of all we have in life science industry. I didn't include regulatory affairs in this because in regulatory affairs only different software we use is ECTD, and I will bring some expert who can go over the regulatory affairs software later on this week, and we'll do a video on that later on. So right now I'll mention that in life science industry, pharmaceutical, biopharma, startup, any scale company, we can see departments like quality assurance, manufacturing, quality control, warehouse, instrumentation, utility, facility, metrology, training and HR, finance and purchase. Now these are the department. Now I will try to go over each department and see what type of software they use, for what they use. Now it's your opportunity. Go to your resume, sit back and see or remember that in which companies you worked for, what are the expert, what was your department name was. And in those days you worked on some softwares, what those software called. So let's first of all focus on quality assurance. So quality assurance department perform many functions. Like it's a quality unit, they are responsible for issuance of document, they are responsible for review of the document, they are responsible for issuance of certificate of analysis or certificate of compliance, they are responsible for releasing the product to the market, they are responsible for writing down the complaints that come into the company. So first see quality system software. Quality system, whenever I say quality system, it means change control, deviation, CAPA, non-conformance, patient complaint, audit and compliance, internal audit observation. So any type of trigger document companies are tracking in some sort of software. If company is small, they are not tracking it in software. Company is big enough, they installed $1 million softwares in their company, have unlimited license and have everybody use them. So major quality system softwares, very famous one is TrackWise. Some company use SAP as well. ComplianceWire I heard and I worked in my previous companies. Caliber QMS, and if you search on internet, you will find thousands of quality management system software providers. It's all depend upon how old a company is, how many clients they have. So if you want to explore, you can explore. All these software do is record some sort of event. They are the tracking software for a quality assurance department. Now let's come down to quality documentation. Quality assurance department execute important responsibility of issuance of document. So there is, they use some type of software in order to review the SOP, create the SOP, revise the SOP, absolute an SOP, maintain the current version of the SOP, so on and so forth. And similar to this, they perform, they maintain all the documents such as protocol, batch record, specifications, SOP, work instructions, job aid, all in their quality documentation system, so that any day, anywhere, you can just access and read the right SOP, which should be in the effective version at that time. So the common and most famous one I heard are Master Control, MyQMAS, Compliance Wire, and SharePoint by Microsoft Office. These are the brand name. You may have used some other one. I put by myself. Just wanted to show an example that if these terminology are sitting in your resume and you are applying for a job for a company which use these software, your probability of getting selection is higher. Now, quality assurance department also use software for trending and metrics. Like they want to trend how your quality performance is doing, whether you are consistently hitting the specification limit, whether one supplier is hitting their performance, whether we are reaching toward the failure out of specification, out of trend. So there are some trending software in which they do the data entry of all the batches manufactured. So Minitab, I worked in one of the company and they use Minitab. So whatever batch they manufacture, they just enter the detail in the batch and it trends. Like this year you prepared 200 or you manufactured 200 batches. And out of those 200 batches, we found that your water content limit is consistently going down. Means something is wrong with the process and we're gonna hit a failure limit near soon. LIMS is another famous one. Trackwise they also use. Now let's come to the next one, which is batch record and test data sheet. Companies are adopting an approach where they want to give batch record in electronic version or a software where they can print the most current version of the batch record, so that they can track the number of pages they have issued, so that they have tracked any additional issuance of the batch record. So this is controlled through EBPR, ETDS system. This is very common terminology. There are various software which has their own brand name. So you have to search and think about which company you are applying for, what type of software they are using, and more or less see what type of experience you gain. Audit software. Now, quality assurance department is responsible to handle the audit. How many type of audits? Customer audit, vendor audit, regulatory affairs audit, compliance audit, any consultant audits. So all these audits, they enter their observations in a software where later on they can decide, okay, we receive observation on manufacturing. So manufacturing department will look after the implementation. So this software allow them to track the observation in real time, allow them to track how an audit happens, how many people joined the audit, who was there, attendance, how the process flows, what type of document they have asked for. So examples are EDMS, Trackwise, and in Utopia. Now let's come to manufacturing. In manufacturing department, for manufacturing support operations, I don't know the name of the software, but there are always PLC, big PLC screen, which help you run the manufacturing operation, like open valve X. So you click here and it open the valves of a reactor. So few examples are Delta V and some other. So search them that what are the manufacturing support operations. So if you are applying for manufacturing department, make sure you include these. Further, PLC. PLC is programmable logic control, if I'm right. This is a screen, you know, like whenever it's similar to your mobile. So each equipment has a PLC screen where you can click yes and no and operate a operation on it. Now, environmental monitoring. We know that our drugs are and pharmaceutical, biopharmaceutical are manufactured in controlled environment. So example of those software which used to monitor the facility temperature, humidity, differential pressure is SCADA. Control data acquisition system, something. Search it. It maintain the facility overall parameter in its software. Temperature monitoring is done by thermal chart, pressure sensor for pressure gauge, RH and humidity. Material movement, manufacturing use materials. So all the movement happen in SAP, like which raw material came from where and you used for which process. So SAP is a big software and I can have a separate video on SAP, but just remember SAP is used to track material movement, manpower movement, utility movement, any type of movement of inventory in pharmaceutical, biopharmaceutical, medical device system. So if any material is coming to your company, it goes to SAP so that you know you receive 1000 liters of WFI. Water for injection. Now those 1000 liter of WFI you used in X, Y and Z process. In how much quantity you use? We use 700 in this, 300 in this and total is 1000. So we are reconciling. So it help in reconciliation as well. Now manufacturing also use documentation. Manufacturing also use quality systems. One extra software manufacturing uses EBPR. Nowadays if you see the tablets are in very prevalent. Everybody is using them. So now companies are making their batch record electronic. You just need to pick up a tablet and you enter that today 27. Even the date and the entries were taken automatically from the system. You just need to enter the parameter in the batch record. QC. So in QC use most of the same software like QMS for track wise inventory for SAP, quality documentation for EDMS. But main different software they use is LIMS. So there are many software similar to LIMS. LIMS is a brand name. You search, many companies are using it. It used to produce label. It's used to record the samples. It used to record the entries of result in LIMS. And then it used to produce certificate of analysis. It used to produce some type of confirmation certificate of compliance as well. So LIMS is good. Go over, try to learn about it. Now training department. This is another department where they use a different software, which is LMS, Learning Management System. So what are the different? They are very famous nowadays. Saba, SuccessFactor, Compliance Wire, ISO Train, Plateau and many other. Other than that, they use SAP for inventory, supplier archiving software. So Iron Mountain and Access, they sometimes give you a software in which you can enter that today I want to archive 100 boxes from my company and there the documents in each box is this, so that when you want to retrack, you can use their softwares. They also use EDMS. And last one is finance and warehouse. Mainly material, manpower and utility flow happens. So they use SAP. Similarly in instrumentation, SAP, EDMS and training. So now let me summarize this. These, I tried to summarize different type of software used in the industry. Sit and see how many industry you worked in and what type of software they used. Try to bring them in your resume. I'm sure this will help in shortlisting of your resume for some specific positions where the job description require you to have such experience. Or also hiring manager feel good that okay, you have experience in SuccessFactor. We are using ISO Train. Both are similar. They work in the same principle. So you can also mention that I have the experience and I can work on this. So the nutshell conclusion is put keywords in your resume in order to get shortlisted. Thank you.